for VP in the past, and he is one of their star players. On cash, he really does step up huge. He's one of the players on CT side will consistently get pop flashed into main and look for very quick frags. The problem is, though, sometimes it is predictable, and he does get found out very quickly.
Yeah, but it's a huge play that needs to be made at times on the CT side. We've seen a lot of teams struggling with the defense on this map, and a lot of it comes down to that information gathering. What can you find out before it actually hits? You need to have good rotations. You need to control mid. And if you don't have the intel of where your opposing team is at, it can pose so many problems. And here, actually, we're just seeing the default pistol run that's come out. It's no longer recently. It's been going on for a while on cash. The CT side playing a retake over towards the 8 bomb site. They've got a smoke and a defuse kit on Maniz. So when he rotates over, they have a chance to just drop a smoke on the bomb and just go for that defuse.
Absolutely. This is a tried and tested strat from a lot of CT sides and Lounge Gaming, just pretty much with Mihu, who's going to be watching as the bomb has been planted. They do have the kit on Maniz, if needs be, and the rest of the team, obviously, with the Kevlars. But that is a free plant, and now here comes the retake. Maybe the key man here is Sparrow. He's going to try and get his way around the back of them and flank so he can get into A main from behind and do some serious damage. But Mihu is taking a lot of damage. Three frags in as many seconds. Make that four for Nip, and it's a complete shutout after the bomb goes down. And now the aforementioned Sparrow is all that remains, but his flank is nowhere near as efficient. He's going to get the kill, but there's no chance of him getting this clutch.
Yeah, that was just a slaughter. Five members inside there, basically at A bomb site. And I began to just set up so many crossfires. So Go Lounge, I mean, it was a little tricky from Nip because none of them came out A main. So there was actually no jump on a rotation. It was basically once the bomb gets planted, they're like, oh, okay, now we have to start this retake. It's such a disadvantage as well. So good pistol round from Nip. They send four members indoor. That's a big gamble as well because that's a very narrow choke point. If Lounge Gaming isn't running that setup, if they have, you know, one or two players looking at door from highway, perhaps, they can get a couple picks there. It's a very narrow choke point that Nip would have to run through, but works out in their favor this time because of the nature of that very heavy retake.
Nip with four SMGs, just the Galil on exist, so all about that farm. It's going to be Pith who spots the first player just trying to dart through on the squeaky door. But Lounge Gaming do have some pretty solid upgraded pistols with Kevlar as well, so Nip do need to be careful here. And Sparrow is a bit of a monster with that Deagle. Maniz is the player that pushed through on Squeaky. Gonna go back to the site. Minimal damage exchanged.
Done decent damage to Pit, but NIP, I mean, they're just making sure they don't take any damage from those kind of plays. So far back, Pit spots that out. He's able to get safely away from that battle. And now NIP can readjust across the map. They've given up any presence over towards the B bomb site. All of them are crewing up over towards A main into the door. It's just gonna be Mihu and Maniz here. They have to defend against this, and there's no nades on their side. So NIP is big advantage, but there it is. Like you mentioned, that push into A main. He gets one, he's immediately traded off, and now NIP, they should be able to storm into the site, but Maniz is holding him off initially.
This is actually a pretty sick turn of events for Lounge Gaming. Yes, they lose Mihu, but the damage has been inflicted. That being said, though, this is where the weapon advantage for NIP should come to fruition. 40 seconds left, bomb still yet to go down, but it is in the hands of Get Right, who's just about to put it for A main. Actually decides against it, comes off the side as a team kill comes in. Sparrow executing innocent. Didn't quite catch what happened there, but that is super awkward in a 3-on-3 when there's a real chance at clutching this. Bomb still hasn't been planted, but it's probably not required anymore. As it's all on Mouse now. Bomb finally goes down. CZ enhanced. Only 6 bullets remaining. He's gonna have to make every one of them count. And man, that team kill could have made all the difference there.
Yeah, it very well could have. And you're right, we didn't see the POV, so I didn't see if that was an accident or if maybe he just, you know, thought it was one of those times where just a teammate comes up on the screen and you're just so focused that you just take the shot. But either way, decent damage done by Lounge. They looked like they had a chance at winning that. They held NIP off initially, which allowed some rotations to come in, but NIP actually pretty smart. They drop a Molotov at the entrance of the bomb site when Get Right's about to plant the bomb so that no one can rush in on him. Alleviates some of the pressure they have at trying to cover that plant. 2-0 for NIP, looking good. Forest is just going to be on a Deagle. Pit on the Tech 9 as well. They know they're not going up against any armor, so they feel they can get away with this and play a little bit of the Econ game.
Yeah, minimal amount of money put into this round for Lounge Gaming. Bomb still drop back. Typically, in this kind of situation from Terrace, you do want to just hold back and make sure you don't make any mistakes. You can always get caught in transition, give some weapons across, and anything's possible. So just play the safe and slow game here from Nip.
Yeah, they've been very good on their anti-egos. I know Yanko has pointed it out a couple times, at least when we've been talking in the back in the green room between matches, that they are very, very good at winning these. They haven't dropped too many in an era where anti-eco or eco rounds are won at a crazy level. And NIP's usually been pretty good. It's a lot to do with the nades, and look at Get Right. Very methodical. Clears that out. Spots one more innocent behind the box. He's going to fall. There is Sparrow. I mean, just as I say that, he falls inside the bomb site. So it's going to be a third round for NIP. It's just down on the knees with... Yeah, it does have a Tech 9, but only 11 HP, and actually Get Right's not checking the corner, so that's going to be a free kill.
It will indeed. Problem for Maniz is he's only Mach 10, and he's only got minimal damage and minimal health. make that zero health as NIP pick up their third round. Here comes the first buy for Lounge Gaming. And one of the issues that they do have, and I think they alluded to this on the desk as well, they do struggle a tiny bit on the CT side, especially on maps like Cache, because they do get quite predictable. And they will consistently go for force buys as well. So I do worry a little bit for Lounge Gaming in these kind of situations. This round means a hell of a lot.
And that's not a great sign as well, just because Cache we've seen recently going back to the Major, it's very T-sided. 10 rounds was the average for T-sides. And if you're a team that's known to struggle on your CT sides to begin with, this could be a big half for NIP if they get the ball rolling here. Decent mid setup for Go Lounge. They at least have Sparrow pushed up right by the smoke in that middle choke point. Innocent over towards the highway box, 2 at A, and they're trusting Mouse to just hold off at that B bomb site all on his own.
Really only flashbangs the bulk of the utility that remains for Lounge Gaming, just the one smoke in Mihu's hands. It'll be hard to fend off this initial charge from Nip. They themselves do have a Galil in the hands of Exist, but we've seen he's more than capable of using that weapon to very high effect. Very reminiscent of the last round here, Moses. Slow and steady wins the race for NIP.
Yeah, still, yeah, they're just using two of their Molotovs now, so using that to clear out positions. They have a wall of smoke set up in mid, so they'll be able to take that control for free, essentially. They drop no one. They don't even lose any HP. Exist is going to be the one toying with the edge of the smoke. Is Innocent going to be ready for this? He does get one kill on top, and he transfers over to Exist. That's a good double kill.
That's absolutely huge. And look, he's still got plenty of HP to his name as well, so he can just fall back into connector. A lot of pressure just got alleviated. Here comes the flash again, and surprise, surprise, it's Mihu. The one fry comes in. Can he get a second? No, Forest is there. Get Right, meanwhile, has picked up Innocent, who's blistering double frag at the start of this round. Gave Lounge Gaming a great little buffer. And now it all falls to Get Right, the veteran. But he's used his Molly already. 20 seconds to play with, and, well, he's just lost his head. Lounge Gaming finally get on the scoreboard.
Yeah, there it is, and you mentioned it before the game even started, that push from Mihu into A main. That's going to be even more effective because of the double kill that Innocent gets in mid. This is a really nice transfer, being on top of that. Exist can't get anything going there, so good round from Lounge, good initial hold. Survive with three members as well, so they get to build up some money.
The problem is, though, that it does become predictable. There's no real plan B for Lounge Gaming on this A site, so I feel like once Nip realize what's happening, they may just stack into A main, try and throw some counter flashes, and just wait for Mihu to basically walk into a trap. Definitely watch out for that one. Pit only has a Deagle this round, actually, so it's not a fantastic buy-up from Nip. They have the weapons, but not a huge amount of utility behind it. Three smokes should be good enough, though, to set play.
Forest, yeah, and Forest has the AWP. That's the big weapon you want to watch out for. Where are they going to put that? How are they going to try and let Forest get the pick? And initially, they boost him up in mid. This time, it's a little bit more passive from Golodge. They have nobody in mid whatsoever, so Forest is going to find nothing there.
Lounge Gaming passive this time. Three players on A, one of which is now darting through highway. Pretty standard stuff. Needs to be careful. He doesn't go for the peek here outside. And Innocent gets spotted. Just the shoulder peeking through. Forest will convert that into the frag. That is a huge kill for NIP. Minute to play with. And now that's complete mid control lost for Lounge Gaming.
Yeah, split up into both bomb sites. That's a big pick for Forest. And actually, Go Lounge, this is the wrong round to lose a player like that. Innocent, he's got to be a little bit upset. He wasn't even too committed. He just wanted to find information, see if anyone was there. And he gets punished for it. Now this B bomb site is ripe for the taking. Both members inside the site. Luckily, there's no Molotovs on the NIP side, or else they could just firebomb this site.
Absolutely, yeah. Draw up the two players into the firing squad. So Mouse and his partner in crime are going to be able to do the work here. Well, that's just going to be on Sparrow now. Two frags are exchanged, but they go in the way of NIP. Now trying to retake on B, and it's a similar situation for Lounge Gaming. They don't have any mollies or incendiaries themselves. They're going to have to come in with flashbangs only.
That was a perfect take from NIP. Freiburg does such a good job trading both of those kills, making sure the lives of Pit and Exist don't go to waste.
Here we go. They're going to go for this one. Mihu's feeling confident. Flash in. His teammate has died. Can Mihu go huge? Yes, he can. Two frags come down. Can he get a third one? He's going to be peeking around the corner and Get Right. Has his AK trained to the head. 4-1 economy broken for Lounge Gaming.
Yeah, they're almost able to take that round back, but nicely done. Freiburg ends that round. Very, very strong performance. The entries, the one extra kill on the retake. Mew almost able to bring it down, but this is a little bit of an off angle from Get Right. That's just some solid positioning. We're not going to see it there, but Get Right catches him a little bit off guard. I think Mihu thought he was going to be a little bit closer to be actually being behind that box in checkers, and he's caught unawares.
Now we're seeing Lounge Gaming pay the ultimate price. Win the round, lose the next. Pistols.
This is that, I mean, we call it the nightmare situation, especially yep. On a map where you need these CT rounds where it can be so heavily slanted towards the Terra side. Look at this, Force is just waiting for a jump peek for information. He's almost able to grab it, but Pit's going to get the opening. Mini's trying to get a little bit too aggressive in door. And NIP, once again, just spread out slowly, methodically. They're just going to choke out this anti-eco. and use their nades very, very wisely to clear out spots as they peek.
Kash, the kind of map where you can definitely make the pistol upgrades work. There's so many little corners, nooks and crannies to watch out for, but Nipper playing this one so methodically.
And actually, Go Lounge, I mean, yeah, there are a lot of angles you can take, a lot of crossfires you can set up, but Lounge essentially just has these pistols and they're playing this like a default round. It just sits all alone in mid. Manese solo pushed into door. There was no kind of pop flash set up towards A main, which can be effective, or nade stacks whatsoever. So this should be a pretty standard round for NIP. It doesn't look like they're going to hit any trouble, especially as Mihu rotates away from that A bomb site. They have the wrong read, the wrong gamble, essentially, at this point, going over, stacking the B bomb site with four players. So NIP's going to get their fifth.
Yeah, rolling the dice, get snake eyes, unfortunately. But as you say, they had to go for the gamble, especially after losing Manese, who pushed through the blue door. As soon as he falls down, B is pretty much their only hope to just stack on there. Here comes the bomb anyway, going to go into the A site, going to be planted momentarily. Meanwhile, Mihu actually with a flashbang, he's going to get the best of a couple of players, finally finishes off Pit, so at least doing a bit of damage before he falls down. Just got a whole lot better double frag for him, can't get a third. Another 3-on-3 though. This is going to bait Lounge Gaming into going for this one. The bomb planted, and here comes Freiburg again, all on Maus, and he's got nowhere near enough health to do anything with this. Maybe just save the season if he can.
This is a couple rounds where NIP's taken this A bomb site, and they've been very, very cautious to plant the bomb. They're actually delaying it once they get into the site, you know, by five to 10 seconds, where it's allowing some of these rotations to come in. That time, it's a couple of really nice pistol kills for Mihu. But even on the gun round earlier, they slowed things down when Getright had the bomb, and he actually chooses not to plant initially. So they're being very cautious, making sure that no one can run in on that bomb site. That could pay off in the future. I mean, I talk about it allows those rotations to come in, so it could actually bite them, but at least they're going to be clear that no one is just going to be trying to run into the bomb site all on their own and get some kind of a clever kill that delays the plant even longer.
Well, this effectively is an elimination match, of course. So a lot of pressure on the shoulders of Nip, who were expecting, I'm sure, themselves to go as far as possible. Now they finally have their five-man roster locked in with threat behind them. However, here comes another full buy round from Lounge Gaming, including an AWP, which was dropped from Mihu to Shmero. Not a great deal of utility to use, and it's got a whole lot worse for them. Shmero is the first player to fall. Incheckered was looking for the cheeky AWP shot before he could fall back, but there's Incendiary's Molly's. The kitchen sink thrown in for good measure, and it comes out double spray down for him. And with Getright being so low, this is doable now for Lounge Gaming.
Huge play from Innocent coming out of the vents, into the fire as well. Two kills brings it back into a 3-on-3. Like you said, Getright, no opportunity for him to trade it off because he only got 9 HP, and there it is, finally. Three kills for Innocent, three huge impact frags for him. This is a big round, and I don't think Force realizes there's someone in Team A, and he's just going to get taken out. That's a free kill for Manese. It's all on Pit in a 1-on-3 situation. He's only got a 1-on-1 at this A site, and he catches him out with a nade in his hand, so he gets that headshot on the Mihu. Now he can plant the bomb, and he's got a 1-on-2. Only 30 HP, but he can make this work.
Only 30 HP, but just a molly in the hands of Manese, so it's not as if a HE is going to claim his life anytime soon. He's going to be holding the angle off red container, looking into A main. Innocent's going to be pushing A main. Meanwhile, Manese coming from highway, and that's the unfortunate situation with 30 HP. You can't afford to go on quad, because if a molly or a HE lands, you're pretty much dead, guaranteed.
Right, I think his only option there was to get aggressive in some way. Pick somewhere to just get aggressive, try and find a one-on-one. He had no idea that someone was on the flank, so once that smoke clears, I mean, that spot had a timer on it, and this is actually insane. I thought Innocent was just going to fall here. I don't know if Getright ran out of bullets and bailed out, or if he thought that maybe he killed Innocent coming out of vents, because he did get that other frag, but that very easily could have been a double and three kills for NIP to start the round. But Innocent with that huge play, that's a big round for him to step up in. And Shmero has the AWP still. Haven't seen that have too much impact just yet. But he's going to take that towards mid, and Innocent's going to push up again. He's out towards mid. Mazinho all alone over towards that B bomb site. And it's going to be a boost, a run boost for Go Lounge. But Pit's going to get the opening kill towards B.
Big entry frag as well. You can see Lounge Gaming trying to scurry their way across before the bomb gets planted, but there's no hope on that, so setting up for the retake. This is where the AWP is going to struggle a tiny bit. Consistent smokes should be falling, plus the Molotov in the hands of Getright. Could be hard to contend with here. The next frag is crucial if Lounge Gaming want to get into this one. That flash going to buy a few more seconds for NIP as the bomb continues to tick down. Getright in a good position to watch the flank. Just a Tech 9, but it is oh so deadly in these kind of situations. Are Lounge Gaming even going to check it? Well, they actually throw in a molly, that draws out Getright, he's going to fall down. Meanwhile, the bomb has been ticking down for a considerable amount of time at this point. Here comes the frag from Shmero. Forrest and Pit both come in with kills as well. It's looking great for NIP. Innocent says, screw this, I'm off. I want to just save this AK-47.
Yeah, he's going to try to. They're chasing him down. That flashbang not going to really blind anyone, and this would be a crucial gun to bring into the next round because NIP is going to reset the economy again. It doesn't work out for Lounge Gaming, and that was a nice change of pace over towards that B bomb site, and that might actually impact this defense moving forward. That round again, Lounge puts they put two members in mid, and now that they know that NIP is more than willing to essentially just rush B and get that opening kill and get into the site, in the future, they can't just rely on one player at that B site for the defense.
And Lounge Gaming are falling into the same issues that we saw yesterday in the Tempo Storm match, where the CT side unable to get back-to-back rounds, getting one round, losing instantly, resetting their economy, and in that constant nightmare.
The economy is so fragile. It's dictating so much in games these days. You could see it here. Like you said, we saw it a bunch yesterday. The Lounge just not being able to put too many buy rounds together. Essentially, NIP is just racking up a huge lead off facing pistols in every round.
Gotta give a lot of credit to NIP as well for just playing this one so carefully. You know, it doesn't make for the most entertaining CS necessarily with all-out rushes and balls-to-the-wall aggression, but it is very smart CS, and that's what wins you games ultimately.
And this is also where the meta has shifted. We've seen teams that are playing this style, Navi, Luminosity, they're stepping up in a big way and having really, really good results. So this change to Threat and buying into his tactical style that he's been calling and he's been instituting in this team has actually worked out for NIP so well. Look at Force using this cover perfectly, finding one-on-ones, isolating his opponents, now lining him up in a one-on-two, essentially, that fight, but not able to get the kills. And now Freiburg has to find this NVP, and he does. Sparrow's not able to get away quick enough. There's only one AK left to save, and it might not even happen.
Yeah, Mazinho backs against the wall quite literally. I don't think Nip realized where he is right now, so it's going to be a pretty tough ask to find him out. However, they are checking every single corner. Still plenty of time in that bomb. This AK would be huge next round, though. You can see the economy is still pretty tilted for Lounge Gaming, so an AK would do the world of good for them.
And they might be getting to the point where maybe not this next round, but very soon they're going to get to that point where they just need to put rounds up more than they can afford to give them up on the save.
Exactly, yeah.
So this is kind of that scary moment. The next gun round that Go Lounge wins, it has to be a very convincing win. They have to be able to build up some money behind it, because they need to string two together. If they get reset, so they are going to buy here. They're going to come out with two Famases. They have some utility behind those, three M4s. They have five smokes, no Molotovs, some flashbangs to utilize. The question is, are they going to get aggressive, perhaps? I mean, we haven't really seen do much. We've seen those peaks in A main in the mid rounds, but we haven't seen anything right off the bat be aggressive anywhere.
I'd be quite surprised, because Lounge Gaming typically are the kind of team that do bounce back with aggression whenever I've seen them play online. You have seen the pop flashes in mid, but sorry, in A main, pardon me, but you do also see it in mid as well sometimes. They'll go for the counter boost, so I'm surprised we haven't seen that just yet. Maybe their economy just simply hasn't supported that, but again, Mihu gonna go for that pop flash. No one's home though for Nip, realizing they simply don't have to contend with it. Mihu's gonna die anyway. Meanwhile, get right on the fadeaway shot, takes him out. Highway has been controlled now. NIP looking to shift through the gears onto the A site. Minis almost the last line of defense here. Two frags for him. Very nicely done, but 7 HP finally will be put down 6 foot under from Forest.
Yeah, bomb's gonna get planted in the open, and it won't even matter though. Forest gets one more kill. It's down to Sparrow at a 1-on-3. And he's all the way in mid. He might even just be calling to save this. So there was an adjustment this round. That was a nice tactic from NIP. They threw they executed the standard A smokes, but then wrapped around towards mid instead of going through A main. That pop flash peek from Mihu to get that information actually gets punished by Get Right, who's just lurking. But Lounge Gaming, actually, I mentioned that they might have to change something because that B defense was exploited. They actually sent two players to B this time, and that's members that are so far away from that kind of an A execute. So very good call from Threat here, playing a little bit of chess and kind of mind gaming Lounge into setting up a more dedicated defense towards the B bomb site and hitting the other side of the map.
Absolutely, trying to force Lounge Gaming into positions where they're going to be vulnerable, and you can see the effect that's having. NIP take an 8-2 lead already on cash. Lounge Gaming's economy, again, nowhere near good enough, but as he called before, Moses, at some point they're going to have to start getting these forces in, because finishing the half on 3 or 4 rounds against NIP just is simply not going to be good enough.
It's not going to be good enough. The one thing they have going for him, and I mean, this is just finding a silver lining, is they have this losing bonus build up because, you know, the past couple times they've bought, it's been, you know, lose 3, buy and win, and then lose 2 and then win. So this time they've lost 3. They're going to have a 4-round losing bonus at the next purchase, so they'll be able to have more utility for that round. They might be able to get an AWP on the board as well. That losing bonus is going to provide them with a lot more options than what they want to do, and there's a good find. Forest falls early. That, once again, that passive setup is designed to prevent against this, but just a good shot for Mihu.
Absolutely. They want to get their hands on that AK-47. It's not going to happen. Otherwise, they have to walk into a trap. Freiburg trying to chuck it on top of the little Go to that. There we go. Finally gets rid of it. Doesn't want Lounge Gaming to get their dirty paws on it. Meanwhile, there is a HE in the hands of Venice, so I'm curious as to what they're planning on here. He is on the B side, so maybe just hoping they just get the timing on it into the faces of NIP. But again, as we can see, you have the luxury of the minimap. NIP will be moving their way onto A, and that's into Nihu. Only a P250. We've seen him get some kills with his weapon before, but Get Right just walks out, wrecks him. No chance.
Innocent's on a quick flank. He could do some damage. If the other three members of Go Lounge are able to get some kills here, that could open up an option for the flank, but it's not going to happen. Two members fall on Innocent. He's going to go towards Dorn. It's really not going to be too much for him to find here. Nice dink from Sparrow, but not able to clean any of these kills off. So NIP is going to be able to stabilize, and in fact, this is being watched by Get Right. He has the timing down perfect, and he finds Innocent.
Sparrow just trying to do as much damage as possible before he reaches the inevitable. Has picked up the one kill. A couple players are fairly low, just a tap away from death. And in all honesty, they will realize he's only got a P250. Is he even worth trying to trade out for a $300 investment? Really not. Freiburg is staying there, hungry for the kills. But it indeed will be NIP reaching the ninth round. And Lounge Gaming will have a buy into this one, but we've already seen them with multiple buy rounds, and they've really done nothing with it so far.
Yeah, I mean, here's the thing. NIP knows this next round is going to be a buy. So what is Threat going to call? Is he going to try and mix things up again, try and catch him off guard? No AWP this time for Go Lounge. I think it would have had to have been a glass cannon, so maybe that's why they decided to go away from it. They have five smokes. They have plenty of flashbangs and HE grenades. And NIP4 still has that op, so perhaps going to give him some time to find an opening pick again. Remember, he did get that pick on Innocent. First round, he had this op. That was a huge impact into that round. And Get Right's going to go for fast mid control. They're boosting up as well, and he already has it. He takes out Innocent. Falls already. Going to keep going through vents. He gets a second one. Get Right opening the round up with two kills.
What a call out is as well from NIP. Again, just switching things up, playing hyper-aggressive. Been playing so slow and steady that Lounge Gaming simply weren't expecting that. And just like that, in the blink of an eye, Lounge Gaming losing two key players, two weapons off the board. And NIP in cruise control once more.
And like ninjas, NIP get those first two kills and they just disappear from the map. They fall right back in mid. They don't continue the aggression. Now they're just going to sit passively, wait for any kind of information gathering. So it's really, really beautifully done in this round from NIP so far. And they're just abusing Go Lounge. You can see on the minimap, everyone just rotating over towards that B bomb site. They realize at this point they have to just gamble somewhere. They have to just say, all three of us are going to be here. Let's hope that NIP comes this way. See what happens from it, but it's the wrong site again. These gambles have not worked out for Lounge.
But Get Right's also playing the bait as well. They've gambled wrong, but that molly being thrown in and the potential frag onto Get Right as well as the flash actually lands in both Mihu and Get Right's eyes. That's going to bait them for a few more seconds now that NIP spotted two players over there on the B site. They realize A should be absolutely free. And indeed, they push through, and we'll find that out for themselves firsthand.
Beautiful thing as well is NIP knows they have the manpower advantage, so Forest is just going to stay in A main. They also smoke off behind them for any kind of a flank that's going to come in. So now they just have to hold off this retake, and Exist is just going to fire through the smoke. He's got a good position, but here's Maniz grabbing one kill, making this retake a little bit more lightly right before it gets shut down by NIP.
NIP, man, looking like a complete different team than yesterday. Against very different opponents, I think it's safe to say, and Dignitas, who I feel are one of the dark horses for this tournament, honestly.
Yeah, they're one of those teams that have shown really, really good form at specific tournaments. They were in, you know, I guess you could call it a slump, but these are beautiful entries from Get Right.
They are awesome, yeah.
But Dignitas, we know they can hit that level. It's just a matter of the consistency in which they hit it. So that was really, really surprising to see them come out. And I think also that was a weird case for NIP, just also on top of just being tactically outplayed, they just weren't hitting any shots either. So this is a much better performance from them so far on a map that they seem very much more comfortable on.
And that's why it's to see Get Right getting entry frags like that, beautiful spray control, as you come to expect from him. He's a really great sign for NIP, especially after yesterday, really off the boil. Again, surprise, surprise. They get the opening pick as they have so many times so far here on the T side of cash. I'm just out of ideas while I'm gaming now. They've tried mixing up, they've tried going aggressive mid, they've tried stacking B, just nothing's worked for them.
NIP is just kind of playing them like fiddles at the moment. They're making all the right strategic calls. They know exactly how to exploit the defenses they're being shown. Innocent here at events, he's going to get one kill, can't get the second. Now he's on a reload, he's going to get punished. Everyone from NIP is actually very low. This is a doable one-on-three. But you got to imagine, there's really nice positioning. Pit's going to be watching that, as well as Get Right's also there to transfer over to events if one player falls. And this is going to make noise, so Pit's going to know exactly where he is at this point. He does fall, but the remaining two members of NIP, he's not going to expect this whatsoever. Both go towards CT spawn.
Yeah, you assume in a 2v1 that at least one player is going to still be on the B site somewhere, hiding behind default potentially. Unbeknownst to him, both players extremely low. But he is going to tap out. Manice, top fragging, as you can see there, 11 and 10. The only player with a positive kill to death. And he's going to back away and save his AK.
I actually think he needs to go for this. I mean, he obviously doesn't know that they're this low, you know, 1 in 12 HP. But they're out of time. They need rounds on the board. And 4 is not going to be enough. 5 was like the average, so you could see if they'd gotten towards 5, that's at least a window. I don't think 4, even if they can get these last 2 rounds, that's not going to be enough for him.
Trying to play safe in a position where really that option has been taken off the table. It does afford them a fairly healthy buy in this round at least. Without that AK, they probably have a pistol with Kevlar behind it. As it stands though, full assault rifles. They do have a fair amount of grenades on both Spero and Manice, but the rest of them completely bare. NIP switch it up again, opting to go for a more passive style.
And this is tough for Go Lounge to deal with because with the light utility they bring into this, with some of the fast pace we've seen out of NIP, you almost feel like Go Lounge, they're trying to use some of their utility early on, and it's not going to have any impact because now the pace has been switched up again. It's not slowing NIP down because they're already slow, so it doesn't impact them whatsoever. Molotov and events gives GetRed a chance at finding that pick, but it's not going to happen. Now just trying to catch them through the smoke, retreating. Either way, though, Innocent all alone in mid, and again, an opening kill for Force. That's that pop flash peek for Mihu again. They've seen it a number of times, and Force isn't going to get fooled by it this time.
That's what I'm talking about. It becomes predictable. They don't have a plan B. There's no backup plan there. If it doesn't work, then you're pretty much boned as far as Lounge Gaming are concerned, as they're finding out the hard way right now.
Yeah, and then he dies alone, Innocent as well in mid. There's no one there to back him up. He falls all by himself. No trade kills. And now again, NIP in a 5-on-3. It's Manise all alone, and he's got to get aggressive. This is the thing. He's got to try and at least find this information or get a kill or two, and he's going to just run into two players from NIP. That's going to get stopped by Freiburg, and the remaining two members so far away again from this A hit.
Lounge Gaming haven't played phenomenal by any stretch of the imagination, but I actually feel that NIP deserve all the plaudits they're going to get from this T-half performance. This has been a masterclass.
Yeah, they're just picking them apart at this point. This is really, really good stuff. Really good calling from Threat.
Can see why they are considered to be a pretty damn strong cash team. And with Pit back in the team again, and Threat on the steering wheel, things are looking pretty good. Lounge Gaming, hoping again, praying it's going to be a B push, and to be fair, they aren't going to get those prayers answered, but it's from GetRight who gets the double spray again. NIP move to a convincing lead. Well, it's been convincing for a long time, to be fair. Lounge Gaming now just hoping for 3 rounds on the first half.
GetRight's going to go for the auto sniper. Maybe take that, have a little bit of fun with it. Maybe take it over towards the B bomb site and just plug some bullets right through the smoke, see if he connects with anything.
With it being the last round, I think the idea is maybe to spam through mid. If that doesn't work, can juggle the weapons and then obviously just go back and get the AK.
They've got 3 auto snipers and AWP right now as well. Freiburg's just juggling his guns, bringing them forward to an advanced position, and GetRight's watching for a push. Sparrow might just walk right into this.
Finally, we do see a mid boost from Go Lounge, but too little too late, really. It's not going to do a great deal. Maybe they can get a third round, but Freiburg just charges straight through the smoke, lands himself the frag, and Lounge Gaming all but done here.
Yeah, again, just this chain, this slowdown, the spread out, watch for these pushes. They're just getting punished at the moment. So really, really good stuff out of NIP, and Exist still watching for this, and he might just find himself a second, and he is. Innocent walks right into it. This is 3 kills that NIP's gotten from very aggressive plays from Lounge. None of them work out. This is going to be a 13-2 half, more than likely.
Yeah, it's hard to see it going the other way. And then quite simply put, if Lounge Gaming lose that second pistol, they are done. They are completely out. We did see a pretty phenomenal comeback yesterday in the Tempo Storm match, but I can't see that being a rinse and repeat here.
Yeah, no, I don't exactly see it. I have mentioned a couple times that this map has been very T-sided, but just that play from NIP, everyone is on point. Freiburg, GetRight, 70 kills for them. Exist with 12, but it's the aggression, it's the confidence in these entry frags from NIP, these battles they're choosing to take. We didn't see it yesterday in Dignitas, so winning these opening duels is helping them so much. And definitely the tactical outplay is a huge factor in this.
The cool thing as well is it's GetRight that's been getting a lot of the entry frags. Just charging through mid, just charging onto sites, pummeling Lounge Gaming.
I was wondering coming into this event, because there's been a couple articles by Lurpus, a couple graphs released of his the amount of aggressiveness that he had at MLG Columbus. because Threat was playing, it looked like GetRight was maybe being over-aggressive just to try and compensate for that, just to help out at the beginning of these rounds. I was curious to see how much aggression we were going to continue to see out of him moving forward with Pit back in the lineup. And it's not as much as it was at Columbus, but it's definitely used in spots. I mean, he's still being that very, very aggressive player, which is cool to see. It's just a little bit more reason on the timing of when he decides to do that. Those two entry frags out mid of him just barreling out with a pop flash, going into vents, grabbing two kills on Innocent, and one more in Checkers. So that was really, really cool to see. The CT side now, though, what do they have in store for us? Because they're not going to do this retake on A strategy. GetRight's going to be a lone member at A, and he's actually going to walk up to A main and try and peek into this. He's got to be a little bit careful, and there he is. Pull it spotted out, and he gets punished.
Yeah, Instadinct Exist is going to have to try and come in and see if he can stop the initial charge, but Lounge Gaming taking a page out of the textbook of NIP, not going to be going in too aggressively right here. Actually, still setting up for some smokes. NIP staying in position by and large through connector. Still have a player on B. And just Exist, who's trying to hold the angle as the smoke has landed onto the site. Here comes another one. It's going to be landing next to the car. They're going to try and force him away. And that bomb star has been planted. Okay, finally, it goes down. And now NIP have all the pressure on their shoulders once more.
There's two members from Go Lounge still in A main, and that bomb is not planted for them. So this smoke on Freiburg, this could do some work.
Absolutely could. They're going to charge in right behind it. Here we go. Can Lounge Gaming hold off the push? They have Manese, who comes up from behind, very nearly whiffs his opportunity. Behemoth Mouse are both going to get themselves killed. Second kill for Manese. Looking good. Mihu comes in. And finally, Lounge Gaming have something to get excited about.
Yeah, I mean, that at least buys them a little bit of a chance here to try and roll something back. Still plenty of ways to go. NIP, they don't have to buy into this round with all the rounds that they have to play with. They're 10 rounds ahead at the moment, but they're still going to invest into this. In fact, not even saving any money for potentially an AWP in that fourth round. But they do have the armor, 5.7s, pistols. They only have one smoke to utilize. That's on GetRight. And he's going to use it right off the bat. Smoke up A main. But look at the aggressiveness towards mid. Is Sparrow going to be ready for it? He is. Manese also grabs one. Damage dealt onto Exist. So nicely done from Lounge to at least hold this off initially.
Well, first hurdle has been navigated from Lounge Gaming, but plenty more to come. Looks like they're going to be okay for this round. Being the force up from NIP, but you did see the difference already as well from the two teams. When Lounge Gaming conceded the first round, they played a very B-centric stack. Whereas NIP went for the jugular through mid. It didn't pay off for them, but maybe that's a declaration of intent that they are going to look to expose that as much as possible. Very nearly landed the frag though. The CZ, two players are pretty low. NIP may be hungry just to take a couple weapons away from this round if they can.
Well, there's one. Yeah, there's one from GetRight. They have a couple more low members, but Lounge should be able to handle this pretty well from here on out.
And with the weapon being dropped on top of the hut as well, there's no chance of NIP getting their hands on it. So there we go. Comfortable round in the end for Lounge Gaming. We lost the one player of Sparrow. NIP on the eco. This is Lounge Gaming's chance to start to get some traction now in this matchup.
Yeah, and this is also where those MAC-10s can really build up some bonus money because there's no armor on the NIP side. They have to have full saves. No one's even upgrading a pistol. Just all five USPs. So good chance here for Lounge to get out of this round without taking too much damage, if any at all. Just send those MAC-10s forward, trying to get them to farm up, build up a little bit of bank so you can sustain some losses moving forward. And then we're going to see that first gun round come out.
Yeah, totally understandable why NIP wouldn't go for any upgrades. They've got such a huge round buffer. They don't need to, really. They can just bide their time, wait until they have a really solid buy, and then go for it. And make sure they make it count. Again, all five players this time will be occupying mid. This does give them a faster rotation as well to both sides if they do hear the bomb being planted. Awesome movement. And here we go. They're going to be starting to charge through. Oh, Freiburg has landed himself the kill into Innocent. This round could get interesting, although Pit has just fallen to the hands of Mihu. Mihu down to 35 HP. Sparrow with the MAC-10. Is he going to be farming up the money, as you mentioned before? But GetRight has MAC-10 in his own hands. Nearly catches up. Sparrow in connector is going to be giving chase. And should be landing this kill. No, the aim punch just denies the kill from him. And now Freiburg steps up to the plate with the USP. Going to be trying to bag himself the kill. Guesses the wrong way. How did Sparrow survive that? I have no idea. 2 HP.
Yeah, that's pretty unreal. Cool from Nip, though. As soon as they see any kind of a contact in mid, they just three members just bum rush into that connector and grab the opening kill. Could have made something happen from it, but Lounge sustains from there on out. So we have this opening by GetRight on the P90. Not a lot of utility behind it. They do have five smokes, but Forrest and Pit without any kind of flashbang or HE grenade. Only one kit on GetRight as well with that P90. You can just see the work he put into the first half. 120 ADR.
pretty solid plays. Yeah, as you say, the P90 is going to be the lone weapon on the A site itself. 50 bullets of doom and misery if you walk into that. Oh, he gets caught with his flashbang up, but actually won't be punished for that one. Finally goes down, did land a dink onto Mazinho, so he's down to 7. And now Freiburg briskly moving through A main. Are they going to line up for him? Double spray down for him. He's looking for a third as well. He does get the third, actually. Huge individual performance from Freiburg, and now that leaves Forrest and Pitt the chance to clutch this round out. And again, I just saw you shaking your head. The bomb isn't planted for A main. This is an absolute horror show for Lounge Gaming. Forrest is just going to hold down on this one, and Pitt playing the bodyguard. Lounge Gaming, what is happening?
Even if Pitt wasn't there, he might have still got the defuse, and that's the same mistake they made in the pistol round. This time they get punished for it. Beautiful play from Freiburg on that quick flank. This was really, really good stuff. And he even gets that third somehow right at the end. That last bullet connects, but Lounge Gaming a massive mistakes. Even the second player was even farther away. He was out way, way back, so he wasn't even in A main whatsoever, so that is heartbreaking for Lounge Gaming trying to make this comeback happen. Nice retake from Nip off the back of that triple kill from Freiburg. But still, not the greatest economy. You can see Getright only has a CZ. Pitt's on the UMP, and it's a pretty solid buy out of Lounge. They have an AWP, they have 4 AKs, and plenty of utility to utilize. So a chance here to reset, but they cannot afford any more of those mistakes.
And that's why, as you mentioned, it was such a heartbreak, because you see the economy of Nip is low after losing the round. What is going to be if they lost that one there? What happens if it's a 13-6? Then Lounge Gaming can get themselves right back into this game and see the importance of round 19, but that's in the past. Got to focus on the present. NIP still certainly not out of the woods just yet. Lounge Gaming looking to play slow. Bomb has been dropped. Declaration of intent. We're not going to see any aggression just yet.
But Nip has shown early on already, they do a reverse boost, and Freiburg is able to get that quick flank. So Nip has shown very early on in this half that they're willing to go for those aggressive plays, those aggressive boosts. So you could see Go Lounge, they have to respect that. They have to be very, very cautious that more aggression is going to come out. Here's the boost from Innocent. Pitt is playing just underneath, and that flash is perfect. And Pitt might just be able to get caught out, and he is. Innocent finds the opening kill. There's the AWP coming into play onto Exist, trying to bail him out. Getright's going to have a lot of pressure on him.
Certainly will. Especially as you've got two players scoring their way up highway, and they've both been picked off from Getright. That again gives NIP a glimmer of hope into this round as Freiburg. Best Mazinho, so 2-1-2. Freiburg is super low. Only a flashbang to play with for NIP. But they do have a kit on Forrest, so they can play this one a little slowly. And get this pick. You see the boost coming to fruition for Lounge Gaming. You think better of it, spraying through the smoke, connecting bullets here, there, and everywhere. Lounge Gaming go from almost full HP to scraping the bottom of the barrel. Freiburg from the side. Forrest is going to throw in that flashbang right now, but his partner in crime has fallen down, and so will he. Solid round for Lounge Gaming, but again, Getright with that double CZ kill.
Yeah, but Mihu and Minis had to get aggressive for that 2-on-2. They both found themselves boxed into the bomb site. But this was nice stuff. Almost able to pull them back into the round.
Very nicely done. It still does hurt the economy of Lounge Gaming. You can see only $800 and only $700 in a couple of their players. That being said, though, this should be business as usual for Lounge Gaming here. Should be able to farm up some kills for themselves. Freiburg down to 1. Exist has already fallen.
Nice anti-eco from Lounge. Not taking too much damage. Nade work is pretty nice as well. They're going to be able to clean this one up, only losing the knees. Now they have a chance here. And NIP, they might just want to save one more. I would actually be very surprised if they forced up into this round. So a good opportunity again for Lounge to build up some money behind this. They still have all the utility they can need. Hopefully, this is the thing. This is what Yank was always talking about on anti-ecos. You have all this utility. You have these Molotovs and these nades. Something NIP is very good at their own anti-ecos is use these to clear out spots. Use these to take away some of that danger before you execute into a bomb site.
That's absolutely it. Let's see if Lounge Gaming listen and heed that advice. As you mentioned, NIP would make no sense for them to force into that round. They've got such a huge buffer of round 7 still ahead that no point rushing it. That's the only way that I feel Lounge Gaming can get back into this game, is NIP making mistakes like that, really. And this time it's going to be a B stack. 3 players on here. Freiburg watching mid. Pitt, the last remaining player on the A side. And Lounge Gaming, very similar, very reminiscent to NIP, just playing it super slowly, hoping that NIP push out, give them some free frags, and then convert from that.
Pitt throws a smoke into A main and then rotates over towards the B bomb site, trying to create an illusion that there is some kind of defense over at A. I mean, there's no way for NIP to know this, but it looks like Lounge, just based off the bomb positioning right out of the round, their endgame has always been this B bomb site, so this stack could have a little bit of an impact. They have the upgraded pistols. Freiburg and Getright making a presence over at A still. Smokes are out. P250 spamming through the smoke. All the meanwhile, the endgame is B.
Yep, just trapping over on the A side. Meniz as well could try and wrap himself through the blue doors and get around the back of any stragglers, and that's exactly what's happened over on the A side. Meanwhile on B, all hell breaks loose. Oh my goodness, this time it's Exist who's stepping up big with the CZ. Two kills come through, 12 bullets left to his name, but he can't move to his left-hand side and pick up a weapon. I believe there's one dead there in headshot. And indeed he has got the AK-47, but he's gonna get picked off as he looks to traverse through onto the CT side. Nip will, however, have a pretty solid healthy buy up this round. The reason for their double ecos.
Yeah, done a little bit of damage that round was NIP, and you could see Exist wanted that AK so badly, but he was trying to be as cautious as possible to go over and get it. So the timing doesn't work out for him. 14-8, back into the buys for NIP, and Pitt's gonna pick up the AWP. It's glass cannon, he's got no armor behind it. He's gonna take that towards the middle. Three members in mid, so this is a 1-3-1 on cash, which we see frequently, usually with a double op setup. This is a little bit of a change. Freiburg's gonna get in towards vents. And once they get Pit in position, make sure there's not any kind of fast rush out mid and over boost. Exist and Freiburg can change their spots, but Sparrow actually finds Exist right off the bat.
And the worrying thing for NIP there is that Pit had a chance to kill him just beforehand, so if Pit connects his shot, Sparrow wouldn't have landed anything. Exist would still be alive, and the man advantage would be in favor of NIP. As it stands, though, Getright is going to rectify that, brings it back to equality once more. Nice kill, very clean kill, manages to get back onto the site, doesn't lose a single point of HP.
That's what NIP was so good at preventing in the first half. They would get that opening kill and they would immediately get passive right after it, knowing there had to be some kind of an aggressive play to find either map control, to find information, or to find the equalizing kill. This time it's Getright who does that exact same thing, but Lounge isn't ready for it. Minis falls, so back into a 4-on-4. Now this crossfire between Forrest and Freiburg and Vents, this could be sick stuff for NIP.
Certainly could. Flashbang went through as well. It keeps them at bay for a few more seconds, allowing Forrest to relocate into headshot. Gets that crossfire a little bit slicker. And the kills are coming through. Forrest with one, looking for a second as well. Could it be tapping? Actually gets picked off from Innocent. But the damage has already been inflicted. 15-8 now, a nip. 7 match points.
Yeah, but at least, okay, so at least Lounge built up enough money to be able to sustain that loss. They can still have a pretty healthy buy in this round if they can try and reset one more time on Nip. I mean, there's a lot of money built up on NIP because they didn't lose too many members. Actually, now that I say that, they just continue buying out all the utilities, so they're down very, very low. If Lounge can win this, at least they get a double eco out of NIP. That can get them up towards 10 or 11 rounds. And then hopefully you just have to go on a nice run.
Flash into A main, just to stop any charges that Lounge Gaming were hoping for. Thing is, they weren't necessarily setting up for that. So NIP now have somewhat slowed down any potential comeback. Smoke into mid from Freiburg takes away some of the vision. Again, no Lounge Gaming looking for that boost in the hands of Innocent. Bomb drop just to his left-hand side. NIP with a very standard setup here. Nothing out of the ordinary from either teams.
Now Lounge taking this one very, very slowly. Sparrow, he's going to get boosted up again, try and find an opening kill one more time. It's only going to be Pit here with the AWP, although Freiburg gets mollied out of vent, but there's no one in mid to punish that.
Maybe the cohesion not quite on point. No one's looking to have that utility pounced upon from your teammates. Flash through just below the boost in case anyone was there, but it's actually Freiburg who falls down first. Nice flick shot from Pit. Meanwhile, Exist is there in mid as well. Great little turn of events for NIP. 45 seconds and now the charge comes back and it's going to go right into the hands of Getright, who's looking for a second. Not going to get it, but it's going to be the last frag coming down from NIP as they pick it up. 16-8, convincing performance, but that T-half was beautiful to watch.
Yeah, that was a very, very sick T-half from NIP to start things out. Give them a big lead in this matchup and they're able to just grind out those defensive routes.
So you can see the happiness on the faces of NIP, maybe a bit of relief as well, realizing they were pretty close after losing that first game to actually being knocked out here. Very similar to how G2 and Liquid felt. There's going to be the Poles who join those two aforementioned teams.
Really good bounce back from NIP. I mean, that was really good stuff from yesterday. There was two different teams, essentially. So it did look like maybe Getright not feeling too well yesterday had a big impact because he was huge today on the defense. He got some of those equalizing kills, got some of the mid rounds. The opening kills on the T side was sick. So just all around really good play from everyone on NIP, hitting their shots. Didn't look like there was any real chance. I mean, they outplayed them tactically, individually, Lounge just couldn't really get into that matchup. It was just really, really good stuff from NIP.
Yeah, I did feel that when the map of Cash came up, I was thinking, okay, you know, if NIP...
Yeah, you did. I remember you said that.
I thought we could have another upset here. We could have Lounge Gaming actually take them out. But after that T-Hawk performance, I mean...
That was the thing of beauty, wasn't it?
It was fantastic.
It just pulled apart. You could see the future rounds, the way that NIP played that T-Half, they were just setting themselves up for that entire half. It was a game plan that came in. Threat called perfect tactics based off of what he had already called, based knowing how the tendencies would change for the defense, knowing, you know, okay, so they punished that B bomb site. That would put more defense over towards B earlier in the rounds. And then they're able to go out mid quickly because it's a weakened defense there. They're able to go towards the A bomb site. They just set those tactics up perfectly for that whole half.
It certainly did. Well, we do have an interview with Exist, so take it away, Smix.
Thank you very much, Vince. First of all, congratulations on staying alive in this tournament. Obviously must feel good, especially after the sort of rough loss yesterday, 16-2 against Dignitas. So I guess when it comes to that match, before we start talking about this particular game, what was your game plan before your match against Dignitas, and what do you think went wrong there?
I think what went wrong was that we were kind of cold. We didn't know it was like game on, I guess, from the beginning. We kind of screwed up and then we got going after like four or five rounds, but we lost a lot of 2-on-2s and even 2-on-1s, I think. So they kind of crushed us. We didn't have any economy. We prepared good for the match and it just didn't work out. We were just unlucky and they played good, so yeah.
Well, for this particular game, it ended up being on Cash, and once you guys found that out, were you really just happy about that? Obviously, Cash is really, really strong map for you guys. In fact, you haven't lost a single time since Threat stepped in as your coach, and the only time you lost was at the Major, actually, and that's when Threat was standing in for you guys, so that's kind of hard to really count.
Yeah, like you said, we lost one game in Columbus on Cash, but I feel like we should have won that game. I think we were leading like 13-9. So knowing that we were going to play Cash here, we felt really confident. And from the beginning of the game, we just went lights out and just got a good lead and just closed out the game.
Now, moving forward, there is a potential that you may face Dignitas again, or on the flip side, you might play Astralis. Now, with Dignitas, obviously, there's the, you know, you might want to get revenge for that 16-2 loss. On the flip side, Astralis, despite being one of the best teams, you guys actually have never lost to them this year. You won both times you played them in ESL Pro League. So because of that, is there a particular team you're favoring?
I think Astralis is going to win. I mean, it's group stage, so they're pretty good in the groups. And I want to face Dignitas again, of course. I want to get that revenge, and we should win a best of three against Dignitas.
All right, and last question for you. Earlier today, we saw Godsend also stay alive in this tournament, and you guys are both the Swedish representatives here in Malmö. So because of that, are you, I guess, more excited about potentially playing on that big stage in front of all your Swedish fans?
Of course, the goal is to play on the big stage, but we have a tough game ahead. We have to focus on that. We can't just think about the big stage now. We have to actually win the game. And of course, I'm happy for Godsend. A lot of friends in that team, so I'm happy for them.
All right, well, thank you very much, Exist, and best of luck in your match tomorrow. Of course, as always, we are going to a very quick break, guys, but when we come back, we'll have Machine and the Daz go over this game with NIP.
Game 3 done and dusted here for DreamHack Masters Malmö. NIP stabilizing after a wobbly game versus Dignitas, now managing to dispatch that of Lounge. Couple of early successes for the Polish side, but not enough to write home about. In fact, they are heading home after that one, and now we have just one more elimination match to be played. NIP will potentially be meeting Dignitas again. We'll be seeing how that one does play out a little later on. Of course, domestic matchup, that's a lot of ifs and buts. But first, gentlemen, we've got to talk about this one. I'm not going to use the word dissect because now all I imagine is frogs, thanks to Duncan. Instead, though, we're going to try and break this one down somewhat. It's Cash, it's NIP, and I think we do have to kind of address the elephant in the room, Robin, which is that we were talking about backstage. They haven't lost Cash with their full roster since Threat had joined the roster.
No, but that's why I keep on pointing out. This is their best map. this year so far. Really good, and you can clearly see the difference in what Thread has brought to this team, clearly on this map, because when Thread used to play for Team Acer, he had a very well-known strat on the A-bomb side, where it's like the Molotov strat, very execute heavy on this particular map on their T side. And obviously coming into this game, compared to the one yesterday, started on the T side, pumped up their blood a little bit. Instead of coming in cold, playing defensive, here they actually got to run around a little bit, make sure their aim is on point with some solid executes. I think overall this game just shows how good NIP can actually be. Even though this was versus CSGO launch, I think versus any team out there, I think NIP would probably give them a good run for their money on this map.
And also what Moses pointed out in the cast is how NIP approached those anti-force buy rounds, which we've been talking about a lot. And in the previous two matchups, teams have been really sloppy in those rounds where they have a Krill advantage. If you look at the second round, NIP had, I think, one Galil and four SMGs, or maybe three SMGs and a Tech 9. But they had a lot of grenades, a lot of Molotovs and everything, and that allows you to clear corners of the map, to get an advantage for yourself. Even though in the end those rounds were close, because Lounge did have some good ideas in those force buys. They did use flashes to clear some parts of the map and so on. They had good timings, but still in the end NIP managed to pull through. If they didn't have as many grenades, if they had maybe a couple of AKs with no armor, then I don't think they would have managed to win those rounds. So it shows how an approach like this can... It's not always about weaponry, it's also about equipment.
And individuals did deliver as well. We can take a look at the stats. It's proof for the pudding that we have got a stronger NIP than we did yesterday. It was Freiburg and Getright at the top of the scoreboard. Doesn't always tell the whole story, but I do want to just observe that once again, Pitt isn't delivering in the fragging capacity, Duncan.
Obviously, it didn't really matter in this particular game, though. I mean, when they were going up against the Lounge guys, like I said, Lounge has like some okay T-side stuff. That's not so bad, but they were never even in the game. The first half was so dominant, it's like it didn't even matter at that point. I mean, you were never going to win the game. And even worse than that, okay, that's still fine when you win the game to have 13 kills, but Mouse over there has like 8 kills, or is that 9 kills? I can't read the score. I think it's 9.
It's 9, yeah.
So, I mean, not really that great by the Polish guys either. It's not like they were challenging Nip, keeping him honest, you know. Nip was essentially allowed to just run away with the game from the start.
Also, this is maybe a clear example of outplay, because you saw in the two rounds that Lounge won in the first half, they did have a good idea and good individual performance from Innocent mostly, but the following round, that's the most important one for Lounge, you can see both times NIP had a clear game plan of what they wanted to go for, and they executed that perfectly. And those are the most crucial rounds, because after that, as we always say, Lounge's economy is in shambles pretty much. And after winning Pistol and resetting them two times, you know, that's when you get huge scorelines like we just got.
And coming back to the point Robin made a little earlier on surrounding, you know, the arrival of Threat and this more strategic style of NIP, especially on a kind of undefeated now cash. Yanko, you've got a new job. You've migrated. Not only is he an analyst, he's also...
I'm literally migrating now.
A little bit of a weatherman. And we can go ahead and hang out with Yanko as he's got something to break down.
Yes. So this is one of the rounds. It's actually round number 10. And it's where NIP goes for this. You think it's a set A strat with smokes and everything, because they did execute something similar. And you can see actually how Lounge is adapting pretty well. They flash in Mihu through the smoke here to get some information, and he gets good info. But Getright up here, being the sneaky player he is, he manages to get the drop on him. So now we can stop it here. So you see that because they had earlier pressure towards the B-bomb site, you can see that Lounge is still committed here with two players. And actually, Mouse is in this sneaky position behind the box. And he can't really move from there because they don't have information. Maybe someone is here. Maybe someone can be even in vents because Innocent is moving. So even though Mihu gave information that there was only Getright lurking in A main, so they might even think, exactly because it's Getright, that the other players are rotating all the way towards B, which is a clear, which is something that you would expect probably. But actually, NIP mind game them even further. They boosted up towards mid, have Pite with the C4 who's gonna go here. And you will see after that, Innocent suspects it, but he's gonna get overrun. There's no support from other players. They're still stuck in the B-bomb site. So after this point, you can also see, we will see that these smokes are still here. So that also limits the angles from which NIP players can be shot from. They can't be shot all the way from here with an AWP or somewhere in the bomb site. So now we can roll the rest of the clip and you can see how it plays out for NIP. Innocent drops here, and these are the smokes I was talking about. So this is pretty safe. They have two players in A main exactly to counter this, some sort of flashing in. And it is just a beautiful round. By that time, the players who are all the way towards the B bomb site, they pretty much can't do anything. NIP can have any post-plan positions they want.
Come hang out with us, Yanko. Come on, easy come round. Back to us. Easy round and easy analysis. Thanks for that, yep. Dude. I'm a fan of that. I like this. With the man Yanko, cool. We're going to be doing that more, I think, as we get to see. I mean, that is the threat effect, right? It's safe to say.
That's totally different from what you would have seen from NIP the last 2 years. Like, one thing they did there, obviously, was not only did they have the smoke strat and the split, but they had map pressure. They understood when you put map pressure on a certain area, you essentially relieve it off another area where you can then go to that area and you'll be able to attack freely. So they held the other guys in the B site. They were able to take the mid approach to A there and get that flank on them. So the old NIP either went in like fairly dry. They used to just send Freiburg in after like one flash or something and he has to just kill people. Or they had map pressure, but it was all solely in Get Right. Like he essentially himself had to sort of know how to do that, like when to lurk to set up the other people. But that's not as good as well, because then the people who are going to the other site, they're not quite sure, what are you exactly doing for me here? Like, what am I supposed to be triggering off? So I think NIP, they used to get away with it because they had such fantastic players and Get Right was so good as the lurker. But when you have a structure like this, you can see even if certain kills hadn't gone their way there, the round made sense. They would have had a number of chances to win that round, and it logically put them in a situation where they had a favorable attack on the site.
And you can see the thought process behind it, that before that, in previous rounds, they were putting a lot of pressure towards B, which forces the reaction from Lounge like this, to have two players stationary there and not to move. And Getright is, in my opinion, the best player at applying B pressure by himself. He throws the smoke towards the entrance, towards B, Molotov, towards checkers and so on. And often he even gets a kill there, which is not something he's required to do. He's just supposed to apply pressure. And that in turn forces a reaction like this, which allows NIP then to go for an execute. You see how it goes, and it just shows the amount of that NIP has right now in their play.
Closing thoughts on Lounge, right? We're waving goodbye to them. Robin, what have we learned from the Polish side's two games here in DreamHack Malmö?
I mean, I don't think we could actually expect them to actually go out of groups. They played Astralis first, and then now and they are playing versus NIP. Clearly better teams than Lounge. I think coming back from the event now, they have a lot to go through. Probably a lot of improvements to be made. We'll see if they keep the core five. But overall, I think that we're talking about top-tier teams here, top 10 teams, both of them, versus Lounge, that's a top 20 team. You will see a clear difference.
It would have been fairer if they'd have gotten to play Dignitas. A lot of us predicted NIP to win that game. If they'd have played Dignitas here, I think at least they could have had a chance. The map pool would have been more interesting because Dignitas is more of a limited map pool. As we're saying here, they managed to get NIP on a map that maybe they felt comfortable on, but it's one of the better maps for NIP, and it's one where we have seen the most application of threats approach. So I don't feel like they're ever in the game, unfortunately.
Thanks very much, gents, especially you, Yanko, liking that. We are going to be taking a break, though. And before we do that, I do need to remind you where you can get all your stats, news, articles, and all of that CS good stuff over at The Score Esports. You can go ahead and grab that one. Before we dive into a very exciting game for very many reasons, I said I wanted more drama in CS. Kyoshima going up against his old team. Now we're going to be having FaZe Envy. We're going to be having all of that drama and more coming up after the break. So tune yourselves in, guys. Do not move a muscle, and we'll be back with FaZe versus Envy.